Welcome to the Music Room. I'm Duncan Taylor. We're here in our third installment of our Synergistic Setups video series, wherein we pair pieces of gear that might be unlikely pairings. They might be likely pairings, but the general characteristic is that they are synergistic together. Part of the audiophile hobby is trying to find synergy between different companies' designs, maybe from different eras of time. And that's what we've got today, and that's what we do in this video series, is that we find products that work together in our extensive warehouse full of hi-fi audio used gear. Because of that, we get these opportunities to try interesting combinations. Besides that, there's no rhyme or reason to this pairing other than I wanted to try to find possibly the best synergistic pairing I could for our lovely NAD M33 amplifier. Now, we usually keep this in our listening room at the music room. We also have on hand a mod right usually in this room. Now, it's not brand new, but it's new enough and it's got state-of-the-art new enough technology that people are still talking about it like it's brand new. I mean, it's an exciting digital product that features, you know, the state-of-the-art Purifi amplifier modules. So we've had a chance to cycle a bunch of speakers in and out of this room and hear the synergy that they might have with the M33. I am a testing technician at the music room, and I've always been curious about, you know, whether or not I could find an even more synergistic pairing. You know, the M33 does great on Harbeths. It does great on a lot of speakers, a lot of very, very typical speakers. It's quite speaker load agnostic. Is there a type of speaker, I wondered, that really makes this thing's beauty come out and really kind of show what the M33 can do? The other day, I got a whole bunch of ProAc speakers from a former collector. But this pair specifically, as I was testing and listening to them, kind of rung a bell in my head and saying, this is perhaps a really synergistic pairing for that M33. But essentially, what made me think that this would be a good pairing was, first, looking at the way that the speaker just is and how it's designed. It's got a big woofer, and then it's got a very small tweeter, and it's got this giant ATC mid-range. The gist of when you are a designer working with this speaker, and I look at it, I'm saying, this looks like a quite inefficient woofer. You push it a little bit, you can feel its compliance, you can think about how much power it needs to drive, you look at the speaker's wattage rating, you kind of get a sense for the power handling capabilities of that woofer. So everything that I know is telling me that this woofer is sort of inefficient. And these speakers being ProAc's EBS, the extended bass studio speakers, bass was a very big design point for them. So the way that you get bass when you have a situation where you have a quieter woofer than you do a mid-range and tweeter is that you bring the tweeter and the mid-range down to match the level of the woofer. Now, this makes the whole speaker a little less efficient, but it actually extends the frequency response to the point where it's worth it, and it's worth finding an amplifier that can drive that load, as we would say. Well, Class D and modern Class D amplification can drive any load. And so what we're talking about is not a difficult load for this amplifier, but it could present itself as a difficult load for something like a tube amplifier or a low wattage Class A amplifier, something like that. These speakers wouldn't sound that great on those. On a Class D, on the M33, they sound fantastic because the M33's ability to swing a lot of volts at the output gets through all of the resistance in the crossovers and really gets these drivers moving and gets them to sound fantastic. Essentially, I would hope, you know, maybe even better than the designers heard at the time when in about 1984 when they were designing this speaker. Because at the time, the current amplification that you would use on these is a Class AB. And the amplifier would be working quite hard to drive these to satisfying levels. So it would likely be operating in Class B, which means that crossover distortion becomes a thing. So with these new Class D modules from Purifi, there is no crossover distortion, just based on the way that they work. So it's a really great pairing. It's possible they've never had a friendlier amplifier on them, but altogether it's the type of presentation where you're not necessarily thinking about adding a subwoofer unless kind of philosophically, you know, like me, you need a subwoofer in every single system you have, no matter how deep the main speakers can go. But if you're not like me in that regard, you'd be very happy with these speakers because they do reach quite low, as evidenced by the name of them, I suppose. One last interesting design point with these EBS that I wanted to bring attention to is the way that they form their ports. Now, a typical port is just a big tube. Now, when you look closely at these ATC ports, and we'll zoom in here, it's made up of 100 tiny little tubes. And so inside, these tubes actually extend all the way to the length of the port. It's a very clever technique to basically straddle the line between something of a passive radiator and a pure port. So it's something in the middle, closer to what designers would call an aperiodic vent, something like that. But there's a lot of technology going into the bottom end of these speakers, and it created this frequency response that really, really complements the M33. This system, I mean, just bumps. It's kind of silly because you've got speakers from 1984 and a pair of subwoofers that came out this year and an M33 that came out very recently too. But that's part of the fun we have with this video series, and we hope you enjoyed this very funky pairing and hope that you learned a little bit about the EBS and about the NAD M33. Well, that's it for us. If you enjoyed this, please hit subscribe so you don't miss our videos. Well, with that, we will catch you on the next video. Thanks for watching.